There's something about your digital transformation that should be keeping you up at night, but that we're pretty sure is not. And in this video, my colleagues and I are going to explain what it is and why you should care about it. You all have many different types of digital transformation initiatives, and what we've observed is that although they're all very different, there's one thing that's very common amongst them. And that's that they're all generating massive amounts of events, all kinds of events. So for example, in telco, it could be connected mobile devices, sending events about the signal strength that the mobile device is experiencing back to the telco company so that they can optimize the location of the next cell tower. It could be an application that's built in microservices, where the microservices are firing events back and forth between each other and firing events between the containerized microservice and a system of record back on premises. Or it could be a system of record on premises firing events up to the public cloud for analysis and back down again. So this is a massive amount of new data movement that your digital transformation is creating. Now, how you move events and the data that they generate in your applications can dramatically impact the reliability, the scalability, and ultimately the performance of your applications. Sometimes to disastrous results. For example, one of our clients was creating their online experience. Now they put a lot of thought into a beautiful user experience. They put a lot of thought into minimizing the number of clicks that you would have to take to move around their user experience. But when it came to their data movement, they put a lot less thought into it. And when they experienced a Black Friday-like peak demand on their application, their data movement technology could not keep up and the system crashed. And this was disastrous for them. They lost millions of dollars. Now we see this type of experience all the time. Customers are coming to us with issues with their data movement. And because of this, we believe that organizations and senior IT leaders need to think as strategically about their data movement as they do about their data storage and as they do about their data analysis. We believe that companies need an event movement strategy, and we think it should be an architectural layer that we call the event mesh.
So we're moving into an era within the enterprise where events are becoming strategically important. Every application that we run within an enterprise is generating events. Every IoT sensor around the manufacturing floor or in the field is generating events. Every microservices application today is starting to be triggered by events. Every serverless, function as a service, all of these new compute infrastructures are being driven by events. Events are becoming the lifeblood of the enterprise, and every CIO around the world within their digital transformation is trying to figure out, how do I handle all of these events and how do I move them and make them available throughout the entire enterprise?
If you start off thinking about the fact that you're going to have systems of record, IoT devices, cloud applications deployed in multiple clouds, geographically dispersed, then you have to think of how do you distribute, first of all, how do you make these events easily accessible to all of your applications? How do you provide resilience and robustness and performance and scale in the delivery? And how do you secure and govern that event distribution to this fragmented world that has now become the norm?
Every single cloud, every private cloud, every on-premise has some capability with events, but how do you create true uniformity throughout the enterprise? Number two, how do you make it self-healing? How do you make it dynamic? How do you make it low touch so that you can truly extend throughout the enterprise in a way that's easy for people to operate? And how do you make it enterprise grade? How do you make it elastic, scalable, performant, to truly handle the number of sheer events that are going to come in through various applications throughout the enterprise? The answer is an event mesh. And so what is an event mesh? An event mesh is just a capability that allows events to flow freely throughout the entire enterprise. No matter where the producing applications are located or the consuming applications are located, the right real-time events will be routed to the right real-time application anywhere within the enterprise.
And how does Solace enable an event mesh? Well, we do this with our event broker called PubSub Plus. And what you do is you deploy the PubSub Plus broker in all of your environments, non-cloud, private cloud, public clouds, and you connect them all together to create an intelligent self-learning mesh that then allows you to connect an application at the edge of the mesh, register interest in the events it wants to receive, and those events are delivered to that application no matter where they're produced in your environment. All authentication and access controls are performed at the edge, and you don't have to do any configuration for these events to flow seamlessly from where they're produced to where they need to be consumed. So what makes a Solace Event Mesh unique? A Solace Event Mesh is dynamic, open, and simple. It's dynamic in that the brokers exchange information in real time about which applications are interested in which events, so that no matter where events are produced in your environment, they're routed to the applications that want them without any configuration whatsoever. We're open in that we provide many open APIs and protocols to first of all allow for very rich integration with applications, devices, and SaaS applications, and to avoid vendor lock-in because we know that you're tired of that. And our event mesh is simple, which means simple to deploy, simple to operate, simple to manage. It's massively scalable, massively performant, so you have fewer moving pieces in this architecture, which again leads to greater simplification.
So imagine a world where you have an enterprise where you can go into a single pane of glass, a single control plane, and you can deploy event brokers anywhere within your enterprise you want. So you could be using multiple public clouds. You could be using cloud-native tooling on-premise, such as Kubernetes. You could have an entire on-premise state that you need to tap into. So imagine a world where you could go to one single pane of glass and deploy those brokers anywhere. And then imagine a world where you can connect those brokers up from one single pane of glass to actually form your event mesh. And this event mesh is something that's dynamic, it's self-healing, it's low touch, such that any producing application can connect in, any consumer application can connect in, and every single event is routed to the right consuming application in real time. So think of that being like the internet. You send a packet into the internet today, it just gets to where it needs to go. Take that up to the middleware layer, up to the event layer, where pushing an event into an enterprise-wide event mesh, and that event gets distributed to the right application in real time. That's awesome, that's magic. Now, in order for an event mesh to be successful in an enterprise, it needs to have integration. And there are many different integration requirements for an event mesh to be successful. There's integration into cloud-native services. For example, you may want to take data from on-premise and stream it up to one cloud, like AWS, into an S3 bucket. You may want to pump some data into Lambda or Kinesis. So you need that native integration. You will have applications like Salesforce.com or various CRM and ERP tools where you need to do traditional business application integration. And of course, you can't forget the on-premise world where you have legacy mainframe, legacy messaging, legacy ESBs. You need to be able to tap that. So imagine if the event mesh has all that capability seamless from within the entire enterprise to be able to tap into all these applications. Then of course, you have to have cataloging, governance, and security. You cannot have an enterprise event mesh if you can't control what applications are producing what type of events and what applications are allowed to consume certain events. So how do you do that with security and governance throughout the entire enterprise? This is something built into the event mesh. So from a single pane of glass, you can lifecycle manage these event brokers, you can upgrade these event brokers, you can monitor these event brokers, so that you can really believe that eventing is not too far in the future to be something that's capable for your entire enterprise. And that's the Solace Event Mesh, and that is what we're building, and that is what we're delivering to the market.